This story obviously starts with once upon a time, as it is something that happened a long time ago. But it is not a fairy tale. Instead, it's about a living fairy who is inspirational legend admired by the world for her enlightening force to introduce an earth a professional care system to upgrade health through nursing. The sun had risen as always. It was mid-1820s, and she was born in wealthy family to Mr. and Mrs. Nightingale. And she was named after the city where she was born, the name that is remembered even today, Florence Nightingale. She was different since her childhood. She flourished to be a different person beyond the existing conventional limitation set for a female of her time. At the time when a girl of her age would enjoy playing, laughing, dancing with each other and dreaming of luxurious life, she could see pain even in animals. Yes, it was a normal day, but not for Florence. She found an injured puppy who was in pain, and her beautiful heart felt its pain. So she took it to her home and took care of it. This incident changed her life forever. From onwards, she believed that God called her into his service to serve the humanity and took her decision to become a nurse. Life was also not easy for Florence. Her dream to become a nurse was objected by her parents. At the time, nursing was not a respected profession. Every parent wants their children to be happy, and knowing how disrespectful her dream was, they refused her. Her long-lost dream, which had been deep-rooted in the core of her heart, got alive, which she decided to attend training on nursing at Lutheran Hospital of Pastor Fiedener in Kaiserswerth, Germany. During her training, she found that patients died simply because hospital was not clean and patients were deprived of good food and hygienic environment. Continued her service and was promoted as the superintendent of nursing at a hospital in London. She thought it was a chance to open nursing school, but sadly, a war broke out. Crimean War. More than 80,000 soldiers were injured, and many died as the hospitals were horribly understaffed, language still appallingly unsanitary and inhuman conditions. Florence, with 33 nurses, went to Scutari Hospital to serve injured soldiers. The soldiers screaming in pain, the river full of blood. Germs, pain, hopelessness, despair, regrets was what hospital full of. Even at night, she attended wounded soldiers to pay to their love supporting hearing them. Florence came there as a light in darkness. She focused on sanitation, safety, clean food, love and affection. For the soldiers, she was fairy, living fairy who cared them. From the catastrophe of Crimean War, there was no looking back for Florence. She emerged to be famous and beloved person. Her name was written in golden letters, never to be forgotten even after 1,000 years from today. she discovered nursing wasn't something to be looked down, but it's a descendant generous of all that this needs for attention and modification, advancement. Yeah, it's only because of her, you and I are proud of what we are, a nurse.
Where it has reached so far through the Nodder Act. Let us see how these two girls cope and deal with this similar heartbreaking situation in provided circumstances. Lakshmi is having trouble after her mom died. She cries a lot, feels alone, and is deteriorating day by day. One day, while having breakfast, she hallucinates the presence of her mother. She hears her mother calling her.
Lakshmi, my love, I'm here. Come to me, my darling. I'm here for you.
She gets distressed, requests her brother and father for help, but they think she's just pretending. But these episodes of hallucination become more frequent, affecting her daily life activities. They finally decide to take her to the hospital. Unfortunately, it's a bitter truth that we have some hospitals with extreme lack of resources, insufficient staffs, work overload, deficit leadership, and improper communication skills. And Lakshmi, victim of mental health, didn't get access to healthcare facility on time because her family didn't even realize that she was having problems. Mental health is also a component of health, which is often neglected and overlooked. When she didn't get any access to help, she was in utmost need for, she decided to end herself. She killed herself tragically to end the series of sufferings. Now we have Shreya from another family, having trouble in overcoming her mom's demise. Unlike the family of Lakshmi, she has a very supportive brother and father. Once they realized she needs help and treatment, they took her immediately to the hospital. Very enthusiastic, cordial, and motivated health professionals, adorned with leadership skills, supporting dignity, privacy, empowerment, and humanity in the process of healing, provided patient-centered care to Shreya without any discrimination, actually with compassion and respect. Her health providers instilled her affordability, acceptability, holistic care, and collaboration with other experts on her treatment. This increased her with energy and resilience to cope with whatever she had gone through gradually. The nurses, doctors, and multidisciplinary team approach, warm and pleasing environment, like love of mother, enabled her to realize how precious the life is and why she has to live the days to come. In one hand, we have a family of Lakshmi, which lost their child due to lack of realization, support, and health-seeking behavior. And other is a family of Shreya, who regained her life back when treated timely. To improve hospital experience as a patient, involvement in care, health literacy, quality measures, patient safety, financial security, and cost-effective care are very vital. It saves life. Health workforce, leadership and stewardship, health financing, medical products, vaccination and technology. In conclusion, nurses can be a voice to lead by improving access to care, enabling people-centered approach to health and by ensuring the voices are heard by concerned authority. We need to speak loud and clear, standing together as one, as it is no longer acceptable to deny healthcare as human right. May our efforts to save life never decline.